Presentation-wise, Luminous Arc for the DS is largely unappealing. I know not to expect too much out of graphics when it comes to like DS games, but I never expected something that could easily be done on Game Boy Advance to have frame rate stutters this bad. Furthermore, except for the very intro anime FMB, there aren't any interesting story cutscenes, but instead text dialogues to read with two talking characters in the background. So you have, you just have two character sprites in the background, they just have text dialogues, which is simple, which is a typical JRPG thing that they do. While it's impressive that this DS game actually features voice acting, you know, a DS game with voice acting is always a surprising thing. Much of the script is just too corny and seems geared towards little kids. The most ironic thing is that little kids definitely won't have the patience to endure this kind of unappealing presentation. But I'm not a little kid, and I actually had quite a lot of patience for this game. The strategy RPG gameplay mechanic in this game is extremely simple and rather generic. You just keep on grinding. But I stuck on with the game because the story, as mediocre as it was the most interesting part of the game. Part of the reason is because the story is paced just right. It's the regular routine of realizing that you've been fighting for the wrong side the entire time, and then saving the world from what your former allies were planning to do. This kind of storyline has been done many, many times before, especially in this genre. But Luminous Arc is still interesting because it has its own twist regarding witches, dragons, and God. There's a lot of text to scroll past to get most of it, but for the most part, it's fairly entertaining and interesting. It's not really a great story, but it's not a bad one either, and it's really the only thing that's saving this game from being the ugliest and the most boring game to play. Even with the interesting story, though, it can really be very boring. Not only does the story itself have awkward moments, and those really weird, like, coping scenes, the gameplay poses no real challenge at all. I just use support moves on the characters next to me to get high-end levels. So if you heal yourself, you still get experience points. So I just kept healing and healing, and doing like support moves like boost agility, boost defense, which still gives you experience points. So I kept doing that for a lot of the support characters, and they leveled up like crazy. Where was I? And then just moved around, you know, with those high levels, characters, you move to the grid next to the enemy, you just kill everything. It was just like such an easy game. Unlike good SRPGs, Luminous Arc doesn't require any strategies, but just moving your units toward your enemy and attacking with occasional healing spells here and there. There is no strategy involved, even though it's a strategy RPG. The ability to use 8 characters at a time out of 16 is neat, and it's cool that some characters are very different, but that really doesn't change anything about the gameplay. As long as your characters are high enough in level and have pretty good gear, it's rather easy to finish the game in about 20 hours or so. I mean, I beat the game in like 17 hours. So, it's a very short game if you know what you're doing. So, Luminous Arc overall, it's just a game to get if you don't know how to kill time. The game isn't pretty. The sprites are pretty ugly. Even though the DS screen is so small, the resolution of the game itself is just bad. Especially when you get close-ups. It would look bad on Game Boy Advance. And it looks bad on DS. The gameplay is really boring. So, the only saving grace is that the story is sometimes interesting. But even then, the script can be downright kiddie and just bad. Of course, if you don't really care about average storyline in games, it'd be best to just skip the game altogether, really. I mean, Luminous Arc is just, I don't know. I know there's a sequel for Luminous Arc 2. I don't know how that's possible. Who actually liked this game? I don't know. But I know I certainly didn't.